that you guys have to agree. You have to be born again. You have to agree, like, your belief system, your belief as regards family, your belief as regards spending, finances. All of these things have to agree together before you now think of, okay, let's proceed with this relationship or into courtship or something like that. Hi guys, welcome to another episode of my YouTube channel. My name is Olukeyin the Precious Abisola, and I film about faith, lifestyle, relationship, and health. And today we'll be talking about something that concerns me. And it took a whole lot of thoughts and building morale to come and share this topic, because it's a vulnerable one. Actually, it's a topic that has to do with me and a part of my life, actually. And I know that it's something that a lot of people face at one time or the other, although some people have been so lucky that they don't have to face such. But the truth is, everyone at one point or the other has come to a breakup, and somehow some people came out, and after they healed, they became whole again. But some people struggle with it for years before finally getting healed at the end of the day. Why some, it just didn't turn out well at the end of the day. Some still carry the grudges, the old hurts and ill feeling right into the next relationship, or possibly into marriage at the end of the day. The title of this video is Lessons I Learned from My Past Relationship. And, well, let me say it was an interesting one from the very beginning, but it is what it is. At the end of the day, you know, we still had to go our separate ways anyway, but we bless the Lord. There are different ways people cope with hurts and pains, you know. There are different ways people cope with storms and troubles when they come or when they show up. But in everything, the best way to actually come out and cope properly with whatever storm, whatever struggle, whatever the case may be, whether it is a breakup, disappointment from a friend, you know, a betrayal or something, there are different ways people cope with it, with hard times, you know. Some rather prefer to be quiet till everything calms down a bit before they can now talk about it. Why some, on the other hand, they can't just hold it in. As it is coming, as it is happening, they are spilling it out. They are pouring out their mind in the best way they think they can. But whichever way it is, it's quite accepted. So I won't be putting too much details out here, because please, I don't want anybody to come after me. Don't forget the fact that I'm a Christian, so whatever I'll be saying, I'll be making references to the scripture at the end of the day. So please, you just have to cope with it as long as you are going to watch this video. So yeah, my relationship was over 2 years. I won't say the exact time that it was more than 2 years. And for a long time, I've been let's say I'm that kind of person that when issues happen, the first thing to do is to just hold on, to hold it in for a while, and when I feel I'm fine enough, then I share it out with people so they can learn from such experiences. And I'm that person that does not only share the good about life, I also share the bad experiences too, and how I came out of it, or how God helped me through it. Because, you know, when we gave our lives to Christ, Christ didn't promise us a storm-free journey. He only promised us that through every stage, He's going to be there. He's never going to leave nor forsake us. So that is our confidence. So my relationship was 2 years plus, yeah, and things came up. Let me also put this here that please, it is important to note that you shouldn't go into any relationship until you are sure God is leading you into it. It's very important to know that if you must go into any relationship at all, ensure that you are led by God and you are sure it's God leading you. And let me also say this, that the fact that God led you into a relationship does not mean that issues cannot happen. Does not mean that there will not be problem. But it's just certain that whatever the issues come that happens, God is always there to help you if you let him. And you know, relationship is not a one person thing, it's something that two of you have to cooperate. So two of you have to let God in if it has to work. If one person is letting God, I can bet you that it still will not work. And if both of you are letting go, but you were not prepared enough, because it's not just about prayer, there are lots of preparation, there are books to be read. So the first question you want to ask yourself in that relationship you are in, did God lead me into this? Or let me just put it this way, that did I seek God's opinion about this relationship? Now, if there is an error in that part, I'm not saying anybody should just intentionally seek a breakup, but the thing is, once you find out that you are not certain if God really wants you to be there in that relationship, the first thing you have to go and do is take out time to either retreat or pray and seek God's mind concerning that matter, concerning that relationship. Not outruling the fact that there are certain standard guidelines that the Bible already gives, whether you pray or not. These ones are like open, they are standard, like they are strong, laid down guidelines imprinted in the scriptures, one of which is, be not unequally yoked with unbelievers. What fellowship has light with darkness, or what concordance at Christ with Belial? Yeah. So the truth is, I'm not diving into the part of laid down standards, although it's very important, but the first thing to really know is God leading me into this? If God is leading me into this, what does he want me to do? How does he want me to handle it? And you can't just leave God out of your life all the while, and all of a sudden you want to go into relationship, you want to go into marriage, and you are now coming to stress God. Whereas on the norms, you've not really built your relationship with God properly. You've not been a participant of the secret place consistently. All you just do is visit God when you need things or when you have problems. You don't even know how God speaks to you. So if you are stuck at this point of your life, like before a relationship even comes in, then it is obvious that you are going to struggle. In fact, such people are always scared to go and pray or ask God for his mind concerning the relationship. So maybe if you have issues with hearing God or with being consistent with God, that's the first thing to actually even deal with before thinking of a relationship. Before thinking of praying to know God's mind concerning a relationship, the first thing to deal with is your relationship with God, first of all, because that's the ultimate relationship of all forms of relationship. Now, once you have been able to deal with your relationship with God, you have been able to keep it up, then you would be able to stick to one or two ways at least through which God speaks to you. And once you are able to identify one or two ways through which God speaks to you, this would help you a great deal, especially when it comes to choosing of a life partner. So the number one thing is, know God's mind concerning that relationship. Does he want you to go into it? Does he see a future in it for you? And the truth is, God is not an author of confusion. If he says speaking to you, if you go through the scriptures, it must actually align with one or two of those guidelines or all at the end of the day. So the first thing is God leading you into that relationship? So the second thing is, do you guys agree? And this is the aspect where a lot of people don't seem to consider. Now, when I'm speaking about things I learned from my relationship, it's good to understand that I'm speaking to both the guys and the ladies. Do you guys agree? Now, it's not wise to go into a relationship that both of you are not in agreement on certain things, because the word of God says that can two work together except they be agreed. I'm trying as much as possible not to make this look like a sermon, so please try and understand. So the word of God says, can two work together except they be agreed? So that's a clear point that for a relationship to work out, whether God led you into it or not, there has to be that agreement. Like, you have to agree on one thing, have one voice when it comes to certain issues, like especially very important and delicate issues that has to do with the both of you. So as long as there is no agreement, there will be issue. And the truth is, definitely you might find somebody that you agree on a lot of things, and some few things are not as smooth as it should be. Now, when you find yourself in such a situation that some few things are not looking as smooth as it should be, but the person is actually teachable, then probably you have a green light for that. Please, I'm not yet a relationship counselor. I'm only sharing my lessons from my own experience. Because personally, at some point in my relationship, we had a lot of disagreements. We weren't agreeing on a whole lot of things. Many things that seemed to look beautiful and rosy initially. By the time we started to get to the face of life, we were not agreeing on many things. One of those things we were not so much in agreement with was purpose. If the partner you want to go into relationship with, either as a lady or a guy, or the person you are asking out, does not have a purpose, either as a man or a woman, it is a red signal. Because it is when you know your purpose as a guy and she knows her purpose as a lady that you can know if the purposes align and if you are ready to actually agree on a lot of things. Because I'm telling you that for two people to actually work together, there has to be agreement. It must three. There has to be that agreement on mindsets, on belief systems. Is it the religious aspect? Is it about the kids? Is it about career? You guys have to agree. You have to believe on something and run with what you believe. Run with what you believe together. And that is when it can really make sense as marriage. Because why do you think they call them a couple? They call them a couple because you are bringing like two or more things together and you are attaching them together. Now, if you're bringing an animal from angle A, and you are bringing an animal from angle B, and they are facing each other, but they are not going in the same direction, and you attach them, please, how do they want to run? It's not possible. The race in that scenario is already affected. Like, it's already a no-no. It can't even work. So, personally, I learned that from my previous relationship, and I found out that, okay, yeah, our purposes were not so agreeing per se like that. Like, Oga, I don't want to be too detailed here, please, because a lot of people know me. So, but that is that. You guys have to agree. You have to be born again. You have to agree, like, your belief system, your belief as regards family, your belief as regards spending, finances. All of these things have to agree together before you now think of, okay, let's proceed with this relationship or into courtship or something like that. And let me also state that, before I forget, let me state that if you are going into relationship at your age, I'm not talking about teenagers now, I'm talking about people in their 20s, please don't be interested in cheap relationships. Like, whatever relationship you are going into should be something leading to marriage, please. That's just the wise thing. It's just an advice, by the way. Whatever relationship you want to, and you can have lots of friends anyway, but whatever relationship you want to choose to go into should be something that you know that, okay, I'm not playing games. Because we are not at that stage where we play games. Except for a few people who might still want to play around, but it's not wise to do that. That's just, by the way, I've talked about being in agreement. I've talked about seeking God's face. I've talked about seeking God's face. I've talked about being in agreement with the person who is asking for that relationship with you. Now, number three, are you comfortable with their personalities? Are you compatible? Now, we have what we call personality differences, and a lot of people are still not taking time to really find out or read about temperaments, to read about personality types and the likes. And people not giving attention to this fact of the personality differences, some people actually end up going into that relationship, going into that courtship, going into that marriage before realizing that the way this guy behaves. I don't like it. You find that both of you get angry, boil like hot water. Or you find that you are not just understanding each other. Compatibility has to come in. Like, there is no how compatibility will not come in. Like, when you have somebody being cold, you have to have somebody being hot. When you have somebody being... I'm not saying that you can't have both being cold. You can have both being cold, and that's beautiful in itself. But there are some combinations that are not even nice at all. And I'm so scared sometimes when I see people go into that. Some combinations are so, so weird. Yes. But the truth about compatibility is, first of all, as I said, you have to know God. Then second of all, you have to discover yourself. Know what you want. Now, once you've discovered yourself, you find it easy to actually pick or choose appropriately. Discover who you are. Discover who God wants you to be. Once you've discovered who you are and who God wants you to be, at the end of the day, you find that whatever personality you get, you find, you won't just go for just anything that comes your way. You will look out for what looks like you. And when I say what looks like you, like what fits into you, like what, when you fit them together, the puzzle is well arranged, is not scattered, it's not disorganized. So that's the aspect of compatibility. Yes. And I would say that was one good part of my relationship. That was one very good part of my relationship. We're compatible in a way, even though there were weaknesses and all of that. And that will lead me to the next point. The next point is you have to deal with weaknesses. Like, be ready to deal with each other's weakness, both individually and together. Now, when you get into a relationship with someone, this is number four now. When you get into a relationship with someone, you are not going into a relationship with a perfect person. And that is why you have to look out for teachability. I will be talking about that as the next point. You are not going into a relationship with a perfect person. They have got their strengths. They have got their weaknesses. They have got aspects where they are lagging behind. And they have got aspects where they are at their best, or they are at the top in that aspect. But the thing is, you just have to first go in with the mindset that, okay, you're not going to a relationship with a perfect person. You have to be ready to understand their strengths and their weaknesses. Now, there are some of those strengths, those weaknesses that you have to tell them that, Oga, auntie, go and deal with this weakness. Like this one, we'll be praying together, but you have to deal with it consciously. Because there are some of those weaknesses that if you don't deal with it yourself and you don't deal with it consciously, it would bring about clashes, it will bring about problems, big problems at the end of the day, in the courtship, in the marriage, at the end of the day. And there are some that, okay, you find out that, okay, this particular one, we have to join hands together to deal with it. Then you not only pray about it, whenever such a person makes such mistakes, you call their attention to it in love, like that. But then, that's why teachability is very important. There are some people, they are not teachable. I will not stress this much so nobody will come after me. Some people are not teachable. Some people need to go and learn teachability. Some people are not even submitted to anybody, not a mentor, not a pastor, nobody. They are just there. An island of knowledge. They don't submit to anybody. Please don't join yourself to such people, Tori Olon. Don't kill yourself. Makpare, I'll not be exposing anybody here, but see, if you are a lady and you find that bros, the guy is not teachable, you would correct him once, twice, thrice. He doesn't just listen, or he doesn't even care, or he just keeps repeating it. You've been praying over the matter, you've been correcting him, he's still not listening. Auntie, deliver yourself before the devil hook you up. It's such a relationship. But the beautiful thing about breaking out of such friendship, such relationship, and such courtship is that if God really led you into the relationship, the courtship, the marriage, like, I'm not even talking about marriage because I'm not going into that angle. But if God led you to that friendship, that relationship, that courtship, if you are noticing some of these things, the first thing to actually do is go back to God. And tell God that, God, this and this is what I see. what do I do? In some cases, the Lord will just point your attention to the fact that you need to just pray for the person. But in some cases, the Lord will tell you it is a red sign. My daughter, run for your life. I think I should end this video here. Thank you so much for listening to me. If you're being blessed or you enjoyed this video, please do well to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Like, please hit this subscription button. Yes, please do that. Thank you very much. And in my next episode, I'll be talking a bit more about my breakup experience. Like, briefly. Just briefly. Alright, see you in my next video. Bye.